Hello everyone, this is Adionic. Today we are going to learn how to write the three important matrices used in graph theory. They are the incident matrix represented by A, the tison matrix represented by B, and the cut set matrix represented by capital Q. So for understanding how to write the matrices, I am considering a graph like this. For example, I named the nodes A, B, C, and D like this, and the branches 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and assigned arbitrary directions. So let's first move on to incident matrix A. So for writing incident matrix, you have to remember just one point. If for a node, the branch is incident on it and is towards it, we give a negative 1. That is, if the branch is incident on the node and is directed towards it. And alternatively, if we give positive 1, if the branch is incident on that node and is directed away from it. And obviously, we give 0 if it is not at all incident on that node. So, we are going to write the incident matrix for this graph right here. So for easiness, we just write the nodes here and the branches here, so that you can easily write the matrix. Now we first consider the first node, that is A here, and here 1 is directed towards it and is incident on it. So we give minus 1. And other the 4 is also incident on it, but away from it, so give positive 1. Now in no other branch is incident on it, so every other branch gets a 0 value in the incident matrix. Now we take B. Similarly, 2 and 4 is incident on it towards it, and 5 is directed away and incident on it. All others are not at all incident on it, so we give 0. Now for the C, 3, 6 and 5 all are incident towards it. 3, 5 and 6 all other gets as 0. Now D, we have 1, 2, 3 and 6 away from it. 1, 2, 3 and 6 away from it, the other 2 0. So this is the incident matrix for this graph. So for doing problems, we normally write the reduced incident matrix, which we can find out by considering any one node which is convenient as the reference node here. The D here is the most convenient reference node. So we just have to eliminate the row obtained by node D to obtain the reduced incident matrix. So this is the reduced incident matrix of this graph. Now to write the tison matrix, we draw the tree of this graph and mark the links with the dotted lines. So here I obtained a possible tree and marked the links as shown. Also, don't forget to mark the directions. Now to write the tison matrix, you have to know the convention as in incident matrix here. That is, if the direction of the branch is same as that of the link, then we get a positive sign. Same orientation plus 1. Opposite orientation, we get a negative sign. And if, as we are talking about a loop right here, if the branch is not included in the loop, we give a 0 value in the tison matrix. So now for writing the tison matrix B equal to, we first consider the link, first link, that is here. Let's consider 4 first. Now when we consider 4, 3, 4, 5, 6, the 4, when we consider 4, we have to assign essentially one for that column and particular row. That is, when we consider the loop including 4, we give 1 for 4. That is the positive direction or the reference direction that we take for that particular loop. Now, moving along the loop here, 2 is directed opposite to 4. That is, 2 gets a negative sign, and 1 is directed along the direction of 4. That is, we travel in this loop in that direction. Here 4 is clockwise, so everything that is clockwise gets a positive sign, and anti-clockwise negative sign. All other branches are not included in this loop, so it gets 0. Now similarly, the 5th branch, and it also is clockwise, and the 3 is gets a negative, and 2 gets positive, and every other branch gets a 0. Now 6, we only have 3 in that loop, which is directed opposite to the 6, so we get a matrix like this. This is our tie-set matrix. Now to obtain the cut-set matrix, we again draw the tree and the links as in the previous case. So I obtained the tree, and now we have to cut this graph so that we can decompose it into different cut sets. So first we have to look and identify each nodes and understand which all nodes has one twig and all other links are incident. That is, if we consider A here, only this twig is incident and no other twig is incident. That is, no, only a single twig is incident at that node. So A, B, C has only one twig incident, whereas D has three twigs incident. So we cut at those nodes where only one twig is incident. That is, here A, B and C. While cutting, you should also note that we should cut only through those branches which is incident at that node. That is, if we cut at node A, we should not include a second or third branch. Only 1 and 4 should be included in that cut. That is, if we cut like this, all conditions are satisfied. I took a different color for you to understand. Now here I can cut like this, so that 4, 5 and 2 are cut, and 2 is the only twig incident. Similarly here also I can make a cut like this, so we get 3 cut sets. Now to obtain the cut set, we have to mark the direction of these 3 cut sets. The direction of the cut set is same as that the direction of that twig incident on it. So here we get a direction like this, that is towards that node. Here also, and for just make markings like this and don't make it too complicated, so you can easily write the matrix. Now for writing the matrix, if the orientation of the branch is same as that of the cut set, then we put a positive sign, that is plus 1, same direction, and negative 1 for opposite direction, and 0 if not incident. Now to write the cut set matrix, I am marking it like C1, C2 and C3 are our 3 cut sets, and the branches are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So when we consider C1, here 1 is towards it, so we put 1, and 4 is away from it, that is opposite direction, so we put negative sign, and all other branches get 0. Now for B or C2, we have 2 in the same direction as it is, and 4 also in the same direction, but 5 is directed away from it. So we get it like this. Now for C3, 3 and 6 and 5 all are directed towards it. 3 and 5 and 6. So this is our cutset matrix. Like an incident matrix, this is a reduced cutset matrix. So this can be used to solve problems with proper equations. So I hope you found this video helpful. So please like and subscribe. And thank you.